Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. We are going to draw an orbital picture for methane. Now methane, we have two different representations on the screen. We have the Lewis dot structure, and then another representation that we've seen before. We're actually now trying to show that this carbon is sp3 hybridized. It has 109 degree bond angles, and it's tetrahedral. As it turns out, our orbital picture will look very much like this tetrahedral picture that we've shown in the upper right. So we're going to draw our carbon. And what do we know about our carbon? Well, our carbon is sp3 hybridized. That means it has four sp3 hybrids. And these sp3 hybrids are coming off in orientations that are just like what we've shown for this tetrahedral picture. So we will have two sp3 hybrids coming off within the plane of the writing surface. And we'll try to represent one of them coming off and sticking up above the plane of the picture. We would call that a wedged orbital. And then we'll try to draw one dotted, and that's our hashed orbital. Now these sp3 hybrids, the four sp3 hybrids, are interacting with hydrogens that have 1s orbitals. And so we will try to fill in these hydrogen atoms, and we'll try to draw that hydrogen wedged. It's kind of impossible, but we'll do our best. And we'll try to draw this hydrogen hashed. Kind of impossible, but we've done our best. And now our electrons, so there are 8 electrons represented by these 4 bonds. We don't really have space, but we can try to stick them in these overlapping regions. Like I say, we didn't leave enough room. There's 2 dots there. Maybe we can fit them there. And that's our orbital picture. So I want to point out one thing, a couple things about this orbital picture. One is the number of orbitals that have gone into this picture. To make this molecule, we took 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals on carbon plus 4 1s orbitals on our hydrogen. That's 8 orbitals. Now our picture only shows 4 of them. Each of these sigma bonds in our Lewis structure represents 1 orbital. That's a sigma bond. So that's 4 orbitals. Where do our other 4 orbitals go? We started with 8. Our other 4 orbitals are actually in our sigma stars. So we've shown the 4 sigmas. They're also 4 sigma star orbitals. We haven't drawn them because they're vacant orbitals, but they're part of the picture, but we're not going to draw them. So don't forget there's antibonding orbitals in here. One other thing I want to point out. Typically when people draw orbital pictures, they don't draw the orbitals for their sigma bonds. Now we've drawn them here in our picture on the left, but typically you don't. Typically orbital pictures are meant to highlight the pi bonds in the molecule, if your molecule has pi bonds. And we will just simply draw our orbital picture for sigma bonds using lines, just like we did in the Lewis structure or our tetrahedral picture. But it's good to know how to represent these orbital pictures for molecules like methane.